Joining us this morning on Hot Copy, what an honor to have him with us on the show to give us his thoughts on the Supreme Court resolution, which he calls a win-win. We have retired Chief Justice Artemio Panganiban. CJ, thank you so much for coming to Head Start. What an honor. Thank you.
Good morning. Smart, lovely.
Thank you.
And most popular.
All right, the morning started well, but thank you. Let's start with this issue. Yes. Both camps claim a victory, but yet the public, frankly, feels it's anticlimactic. What a disappointment. Mm-hmm. In other words, people were already waiting for the Supreme Court to make a decision mm-hmm. on the second cause of action.
Yes.
You say it's a win-win. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's start with that. Did the Supreme Court do the right thing?
Bottom line, my answer is yes. But let us go to the explanation so it can be understood by our people. First, let's go to what Lenny is saying through her counsel, Romy Macalindal, one of the best election lawyers in the country, as well as, of course, George Garcia, also one of the best, probably the two best election lawyers in this country. I speak with both of them, by the way.
Okay, all right.
Now,
so Lenny's camp.
Lenny's camp says a decision should have been made basing on Rule 65 of the Presidential Electoral Tribunal rules that says that once the pilot provinces are finished in their recount and there is no substantial recovery, the whole petition should be dismissed. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's see the background. Bongbong Marcos filed an election protest involving 25 provinces and 5 cities, constituting about 39,000 precincts. Now, you cannot open all of that and recount all. It will take 20 years. Therefore, prudentially, the Supreme Court rules, as there are also rules of the COMELEC, the electoral tribunals of the House and the Senate, also says, let's have pilot provinces or cities or precincts. The protestant or the complainant is asked to identify where were you cheated the most. Let us see. So in the case of Marcos, he identified 3 provinces, as we all know, Camarines Sur, Iloilo, and Negros Oriental. Now, that took some time. That's another story, why it took some time.
Yeah.
Maybe we can talk about that another time. But this time, it is claimed by Lenny's lawyer that based on their own computation, Lenny won by 15,000 more votes in addition to her current lead of 263,000 votes. Mm-hmm. So, Macalindal says, there's no other way but to dismiss based on Rule 65. Mm-hmm.
Kumbaga sabi nga nila, sinasabi nila, nadagdagan pa nga yung boto namin. Okay.
Instead of being losing some votes, nadagdagan pa. Well, hindi pa naman alam ng publiko yon. Hindi pa rin alam ng kampo ni Marcos yon, officially. In other words, the report is not known yet. Mm-hmm. The Supreme Court justices probably know, because the report was submitted to them.
Mm-mm. By Justice Kagiwa.
By Justice Kagiwa. And probably they have read it. But I have not. You have not. The public has not. I think it's prudential that if this report must be used against Marcos, Marcos must first be heard. Kaya comment muna. Huwag muna namang, tapos ng recount, tapos na ito.
Talo ka na.
Talo ka na. Hindi naman ganun. Dapat, bago mo sabihin, talo ka na, eto yung report, anong masasabi mo?
Mm-mm.
You know, this is required by due process. I'll give you an example why that is important. Let us say there's a picture of a man shooting another at the back. Tapos sasabihin ng publiko, kitang-kita na yung ebidensya. Nakalitrato na yan. Binaril sa likod yung tao. kailangan pa bang usapan dyan? Dapat ikulong na kagad dyan.
So what about the reasoning from the Robredo camp saying that when it comes to the HRET, the COMELEC, or even the Senate Electoral Tribunal, after a substantial recovery, I mean, there's a whole debate on what is substantial recovery, but that's a whole other argument. Oh, the point is, the dismissal is outright.
Yes, correct.
So, okay.
The Rule 65 says it may be dismissed outright without counting anymore the other, the results in the other provinces, in the other 22 provinces and 5 cities. Mm-hmm. But we don't know yet that yet. So we have to first look at the report, and if it's true that indeed Lenny Robredo gathered 15,000 votes more, and probably it's true, I don't know. Still, you must get Bongbong to comment first before condemning him, before throwing out his petition. Like in that example I said, you know, you must hear first the shooter and his lawyer. For all we know, the victim who was shot must have been carrying a time bomb. You know, he was a suicide bomber.
So now, Chief Justice, after the process of commenting and the Supreme Court reacting, the bigger question is this. The report is there. What action may the Supreme Court take after that? After this whole process of commenting, can they, number one, dismiss outright based still on Rule 65 and it's in the Kagiwa report, or wait for new appointees coming from President Duterte, right? Because it's 20 days after, he'll be appointing after some time. And then the Supreme Court will say, okay, after the commenting, we are still deciding to go through the third cause of action, which is the annulment of votes in Mindanao.
No, not yet.
Okay.
Rule 65 says that if there is no substantial recovery, as shown by the three pilot provinces, the court or the tribunal may dismiss the protest outright. Now, if it does not dismiss outright for one reason or another, let's say it's not true that there was a 15,000 vote more lead. On the other hand, it was there's 15,000 vote less. Example, the tribunal will go through the other precincts in the protest. In other words, they line up the other provinces, the 22 other provinces, and the 5 cities.
Okay.
Because there is some reason to believe that there was really fraud.
Okay. Now, very quickly, have you seen the Kagiwa report?
No.
You have not?
Okay. That's why I cannot pass judgment on it.
Because what I wanted to ask you, if the Kagiwa report hypothetically would say 15,000 plus has been recovered, that would be a matter of fact and not opinion.
Yes. This time, let's say it's a fact.
Okay. Because it would be strange for magistrates to debate on a matter of number.
Correct.
But can they dismiss based alone on that?
First, you must hear Marcos.
Yeah.
Because he might have reason. You see, it's not just numbers. There is what we call in law appreciation of the ballots. That's why there is a judge. It's not just physical counting. You see, these are electronic votes where there is shading. Sometimes the shading is just a dot. Do you count that or not? Of course, there was already a ruling. Yeah. 25% shading.
It's counted.
These are details.
Mm-mm.
But let us say really that there was no substantial recovery. Yes, there will be a dismissal. There should be a dismissal.
Okay.
After hearing Marcos.
Uh-oh.
Okay? Okay. But Marcos says, all right. But I have a third cause of action. Let's say you dismiss this. But
the Marcos camp sees the third cause of action as a separate course of action.
Precisely. That's why it's 1, 2, 3. The court, in its order in August of 2017, it specified the three causes of action. And the court dismissed the first. And there was no appeal on that. Mm-hmm. So we're talking only of the second and the third. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's say the second, which is dismissed already, is thrown out. Marcos says, just a minute, I still have my third cause, What is his third cause? He claims that in three provinces in Mindanao, Maguindanao, Lanao del Sur, and Basilan, there was massive terrorism. There was massive fraud, such that the results in all the provinces must be annulled. He's not saying we must recount the ballots. It's a separate cause of action. That's his answer to the claim of Makalintal that, why did you not include the three provinces to be recounted? Well, George Garcia says, precisely, we did not include them because they're not part of the second cause of action. They're part of a separate cause of action where there is a different solution. What we're asking in the second cause of action is recount. Mm-mm. Let's look at the ballots one by one. In this other cause of action, he's not asking for to look at the ballots one by one. What he wants is a wholesale annulment of all the ballots because they are unreliable. Ghost ballots were put in, pre-shaded already, and just put into the machines. That's his allegation. All right. There are many problems there. That's why it is prudential for the court to say, oh, just a minute. Let's have comments first. This time, important ang comment ni Lenny. Now, what are the questions there? Why is it difficult to go into that? Firstly, there has been no precedent. And the rules of the Presidential Electoral Tribunal does not cover them. That's why in my column in the Inquirer, I said, let's have rules first.
Wait, that's very interesting. Yeah. Does the Presidential Electoral Tribunal actually have the power to annul an election or call for a failure of elections and decide we are not counting any of those?
Yes, all right.
Do they have that
That's
power?
That's a very good question. As I said, you're smart.
No, go on. But do they
have... You should have been a lawyer.
No, do they have that power?
Yes, that is one of the questions that the court wants to know. First, do we have jurisdiction? Does the Presidential Electoral Tribunal have jurisdiction? You know, the PET rules cover only two major controversies. The first is quo warranto. But that's not an issue here. The second is recount, which is election protest. There is no statement that there is no part in the rule that says the Presidential Electoral Tribunal, not the Supreme Court.
Yeah.
These are two different entities.
Yeah.
All right. The Presidential Electoral Tribunal, does it have the power to declare void an election? Because that is, in legal parlance, what Marcos is doing to declare a failure of election. Mm-hmm. The election failed because the voters were coerced. There was massive province-wide fraud. Mm-mm. In other words, the birds and the bees voted as in the past.
Okay. Now, in your column, which I had read, you give four options. And the fourth option, I'll go straight to that, is you write in the Inquirer, is you want both to submit position papers or proposed rules,
yes,
right? When it comes to the third cause of action.
Yes.
Now, if I were Robredo's camp, why would I agree, right, to giving the PET the power to annul an election?
I didn't say the PET should have the power. You know, I have limited space in the Inquirer.
Okay.
That's why I have to explain it.
Okay.
It's not just rules.
Okay.
The first question is, as we were discussing, does the PET have jurisdiction? Does the PET have... I already explained the rules of the PET cover only quo warranto and election protest.
So the answer...
Not failure of election.
So the answer is no.
Just a minute.
Okay.
Let me explain.
Okay.
You're so fast.
Okay.
Sharp.
No, okay, go
You're
on.
Sharp. You should examine witnesses.
But go
in court. Okay. 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 I'm trying to explain this so that our lay people who are not lawyers will understand. Failure of election is a power given by law, by the election code to the COMELEC. That's expressly stated. The question is, does the Presidential Electoral Tribunal have the same power? That's the first question. Ole, assuming it does, how will it exercise such power? There are no rules. So we must first make the rules.
But who makes the rules?
The Supreme Court.
Then they give the power to themselves? I mean...
The rules of court are made by the Supreme Court.
Okay, go on.
So the rules of the tribunal are also made by the tribunal. That will take time. Because you must hear the parties again. They are affected, remember. You don't make rules, you don't act, unless you hear the parties. That's part of due process. Essential part. As we say, before you strike me, hear me first. Yeah. Then if I'm not okay, you strike me. But hear me first, okay?
Okay.
Now, that's not enough. That's not enough. After preparing the rules, what is the consequence? Let's say, all right, there is the proof. It will take time. There are witnesses that you must present. This is difficult to prove. We all know what happened during the elections, but he might know something we don't know. Let him present evidence. Let us assume that he's able to prove that. The question is, all right, you annul the elections. What is the solution? Proclaim him winner? Not yet. New election. That's what's provided by the election code. If there is a failure of election, call for a new election.
So this is far more complicated
It's complicated.
Going to the third cause of
action. It's quite complicated.
Because there's an assumption on, it seems, the lawyers' minds, because Attorney George Garcia said, if the third cause of action is acted upon and it's annulled, we calculate that we are up by 45,000 votes. So that's a whole issue of math, pa.
Yes, I'll give you the mathematics. And
What you're saying is, wait, hypothetically, if that happens, you can't even declare him the winner.
Not yet. The solution, even in the COMELEC, when the COMELEC declares a failure of election, nobody's proclaimed winner because the people must be heard.
They end up disenfranchised.
Then enfranchise them, have a new election. That is the solution. So it will take time, it will take years. You know, it's like in basketball. It's not just a three-point shot. It is shooting on the other side's goal. The question is, when you shoot at the other side's goal, that's not in the rules. Is that counted?
Yeah. But then, the question now, CJ, is what about justice delayed is justice denied? I mean,
of course.
This is also a political office.
Of course.
In the U.S., we've seen so many issues when it comes to who really won. Remember the Al Gore situation when there was a whole issue on the count in Florida. And yet, he came out and said, even if I won the popular vote, I'm rephrasing, is let's respect.
That's true. You know, Al Gore, when I was Chief Justice, came to the country. Just as an aside, since you brought up Al Gore, I had a chance to talk with him because we were guests at a function, and we were both going to speak.
Okay.
But we came early.
Yeah, like, so quickly.
And I said, Mr. Vice President, he was Vice President, he was candidate. I said, you know, you were cheated in Florida. Because the governor of Florida
was the brother.
Is the brother of your opponent.
Yeah.
Not only that, the chairman of the COMELEC was appointed by the brother. And the chairman of the COMELEC is just a member of the cabinet, not an independent body. Unlike here, the COMELEC is an independent body. Why did you not complain? And also, the Supreme Court that decided it, decided on the basis of strict partisan lines. The five justices, there are only nine justices in the Supreme Court. The five justices of the Supreme Court of the United States, appointed by Republican presidents, all voted for George Bush.
I don't
George
want to take
Bush.
Time on this, but anyway, but Al Gore said...
Al Gore said, there is a... Mr. Chief Justice, I agree with you, but there is, you know, there's a factor bigger than myself, and that's my country.
So then, after that statement, I'd like to turn now to our local Supreme Court, right? There is the country. The more this drags on is not good for the Filipino people, given the options you said, which is quite, it's an eye-opener that, okay, if the votes are annulled, you think you can proclaim him under the rules, you'd need new elections. So that's a whole different process.
Yeah.
Then you talk about the rules itself. It takes long. There's less than 3 years to go, Chief Justice. So based on that, and the algorithm experience of there is the country.
Yes.
Shouldn't the Supreme Court at this point make it clear to the public already, based on the second cause of action and Rule 65, after the comments have been received, I mean, to bite the bullet and make a decision?
Okay, let's do it part by part. What do we do with second cause of action? What do we do with the third? Okay, the second cause of action is really simple. Once the report comes out and the comment is submitted within 20 days, the court can decide that. And assuming really that there is no substantial recovery, the court should dismiss that cause of action. Now, let's go to the third. The court listens after 20 days. It's also 20 days for comment. And the court says, oh, we don't have jurisdiction.
On what?
To take up the third cause of action. We don't have that power.
Yeah.
In fact, our rules do not include that, that we can take that on. So, sorry, we don't have jurisdiction. We dismiss it also. Finish. All right, no? Now, they can also say, I'm not preempting them because they have to study, because we have to hear Lenny first. Lenny is the one going to be prejudiced there. So she must be heard and she must explain. I'm not going to lawyer for her either. I'm just answering your question. Should the court think or rule that on the basis of the submission of Lenny and of Bongbong that they have no jurisdiction, as in fact it's not in the rules, then they dismiss. And it's finished. Of course, it will take time if they rule otherwise. I don't want to preempt the court because that's not yet on the table. Let's see when the comments come in.
Now, after the comments, can Robredo's camp argue that based on Rule 65, hypothetically, if the Supreme Court dismisses, right, can they argue that then you cannot hear the third cause of action? Because Garcia said, Karen, even if they dismiss the second, the third cause of action is a whole separate one.
That's correct. Because the third cause of action, as I was explaining to you, is not involved in recount. It's total nullification of all the ballots. That's a separate cause of action. There's no recount that he's asking. He's asking a different action. Now, the Supreme Court, as I said, can say, oh, we have no jurisdiction. Another way is, oh, that's really included. You failed to include that, so you're no more. This is what Robredo's counsel is. The three Mindanao provinces should have been included in the 25 provinces. Since they were not included there, no more. That's another way of stopping the third cause of action. And of course, another way of stopping it.
It's quite interesting. Go on. It's a whole different perspective, frankly. Go on.
I'm not saying they should do that.
But clearly they're watching you now and getting ideas.
The options possible are there. Now, I don't want to teach the lawyers. They're good lawyers. But what all I'm saying is we must have due process. We must listen. As in that case, I go back. I'm sorry, to that shooting example.
Yeah.
You hear first the shooter. The shooter may be insane.
Okay, now let's skip the shooter for a while. You made your point. My question is this, can it be argued that, because you had said the Presidential Electoral Tribunal doesn't have the power to annul an election. Very interesting.
I didn't say it does not. It must listen first.
Yes, but you said technically the power of the PET is for a recount.
Yes, it under the rules.
Under the rules,
recount.
That's why.
And co-warranto.
Okay.
Co-warranto means you have no...
What happened to Sereno? To simplify. Okay, now this is the interesting part.
Yes.
So if the Robredo camp argues, look, the PET, after watching you today, says you don't have that. You don't have the jurisdiction. Mm. Then the Marcos camp says, no, let's make rules. The fourth option that's given by former Chief Justice Panganiban, let's come out with rules. Wait, my question now is this. Can it be argued that to make a new rule at this point could be prejudicial to either complainant?
The rule could be, we have no power over that. Mm-mm. The rules could say we have power only over two causes of action, quaranto and election protest, meaning recount.
Yeah, but would
we
it
have
be
no
fair?
Power. The rule will say.
Yeah,
they could say in the rule when they make the rule.
But would it be fair to make new rules in the middle of the case?
No, because these new rules were not there at all.
So it's like, you know how you play basketball and they say, don't change the rules in the middle
That's
of the game.
That's why I was telling you.
Can that
like,
be done?
It's like, you know, the in a basketball game, the team shoots on the wrong goal. Is that counted?
Yeah, no. I mean,
no, you already said
it. Yeah, I'm saying, can the Supreme Court, does it have the power after new appointees?
Yes. Let's discuss the new appointees.
The next guy.
Okay.
Can they say, for the third cause of action, all right, we as a body are deciding we have jurisdiction. We are covering this annulment of elections. We are including it in our jurisdiction.
Yes.
Can they do that?
Yes, they can do that. It's within our jurisdiction. And they will say, since there are no rules, we will make rules. But that will take time, as I told you. And then, even if these three provinces, the results are excluded due allegedly to terrorism, etc., that's not the end of the ball game either. There should be a new election, because the electorate in those three provinces must be heard. They must elect, not because they are disenfranchised, therefore somebody wins. Nobody wins. Nobody wins, isn't it?
So do you agree, before we go to a quick break, there was a press con the other day. Of course, there's a word war that happened. Former Senator Bongbong Marcos came out and said, you know, without decisions, it's like 3 years of being robbed.
You know.
And then Lenny responded, of course, who's robbing? I mean, I don't want to get into it. But
yes, but this, in effect, this delay is attributable to many causes. One of them is the parties themselves. They raise so many questions. One question is, what should be the shading standard, 50% or 25%? There was a long argument about that. You cannot blame the court for saying, okay, we hear you first. The court did not just decide 50% or 25%. Eventually it said 25%. Why? Because the machines originally were calibrated at 25%. That's reasonable.
So, kasalanan din nila. Yun din
Sometimes, kasalanan nila. No?
Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.